2 weeks ago on SmackDown, Brock Lesnar attacked Roman Reigns, the Usos and several backstage officials. After that incident, Lesnar was suspended and fined $1 million. During WWE's The Bump, Paul Heyman talked about Brock Lesnar's suspension.
I am not paid by Brock Lesnar. I'm not concerned that Brock Lesnar can afford to pay the $1 million. My concern is for SmackDown, from whose ass does Brock Lesnar pull that $1 million? It amazes me that WWE went out of its way to create this huge surprise, not just for the WWE universe, multiverse, and metaverse, but a huge surprise for your tribal chief, Roman Reigns, and special counsel, Paul Heyman, by bringing Brock Lesnar back at SummerSlam. And then WWE is all surprised when Brock Lesnar is Brock Lesnar. What did everyone expect was going to happen when Brock Lesnar appears on SmackDown? We're going to have just a bunch of smiles and handshakes and kissing a bunch of babies? Come on. He's Brock Lesnar. He's a beast. That's the box office attraction about Brock Lesnar. So when Brock Lesnar acts like Brock Lesnar, we suspend him and fine him $1 million? I have no vested interest in Brock Lesnar's business, personal or professional, but come on, Adam Pearce.
Bryan Danielson was part of the Nexus debut on WWE television back on June 7, 2010 episode of Monday Night Raw. During the segment, then WWE ring announcer Justin Roberts attacked by Bryan Danielson in controversial fashion. This led to WWE firing Danielson, but he was eventually hired back 2 months later for the SummerSlam. After this week's AEW Dynamite went off the air, Danielson and Roberts reenacted the infamous incident.